And Governor Kimembe, you've been, I want us to exit from this conversation, you've been the principal secretary in the security docket and later secretary to the cabinet, so pretty powerful in that regime. And you have had these allegations that even Oburu Odinga says that we had been winning elections but never won. Why? Because we didn't have the system. And there has been accusations, including from Wiper leader Kalonzo Musyoka, saying that the deep state has a big hand in management of the affairs of the country. Does it exist from your perspective? When you served in that powerful office, what was that? What is that?
I actually don't know, because when you're talking about the state, of course the state exists.
Yes.
the state exists. But I can assure you it could be deeper than deep. And if you have, if you have two candidates, say at the rate of 50-50, mm-hmm. and the deep state, or you know, backs one, then you can be sure that that one will win the election. And I don't need to say much, but there's something else we're also ignoring. And I said the candidate must be credible, and appointed and electable, and that becomes very, very important. Even if the deep state were to support a candidate, but we are forgetting also the international angle. Mm-hmm. This country has a lot of interests from the international, and they also influence a lot. I can assure you from where I sat, they influence a lot.
How so?
In many ways that I can't discuss here, but many ways. So if they combine with the so-called deep state, you can be sure your goose is cooked.
Wow. And Governor, it would be interesting for you to enlighten us a little bit, because
it's a no-go zone. So.
Let me just try. The rest of us Kenyans think that you just wake up and go vote, and it will be 50% plus one vote, and then IBC will say so-and-so has won. I mean, what sort of influence, how does it work?
Well, it works. You know, all I can say is that it works. So beyond that, of course, it works. I mean, the voters vote. So you know, deep state also includes people in the villages. I mean, it goes up to the polling station. So it doesn't mean rigging. It doesn't necessarily mean rigging. Uh-huh. No, I mean influence doesn't necessarily mean that you have to rig elections. But I think we are intelligent people. We know. Citizens also very keen to see that popular candidates win elections. Mm-hmm. And if these people are going to, if the preferred candidate is going to continue to ensure continuity, either regime continuity or ideological continuity or material, continuity or the status quo, whatever is preferred, mm-hmm. that is likely to happen. That's why it's very important to have accountable systems, like a very credible IBC, very credible, voting system, the voting registers, that would minimize negative influence on, mm-hmm. on elections. But but a popular candidate backed by the state, I think it would be foolhardy to assume that you can be able to defeat that candidate.
That's pretty interesting. I think, Governor, I need to look for you outside this studio for more conversations.